in general, when you have negotiations of this type, there's a lot of frenzy toward the very end with tough talk and sometimes tough action, sort of leading to a crescendo of activity. And then they come together and lo and behold, they reach a deal. And this has happened in past negotiations between the United States and other countries. The second is that the general notion is that both sides really do need a deal. The Chinese economy would suffer to a degree, and one can debate the numbers, but to a degree, if the U.S. tariffs were to be imposed and to hold. And second, the American stock market, which is now betting on a deal, as you've indicated, and other stock markets, would plunge if it looked as if the whole thing were breaking up and there was going to be no deal, which in the minds of the market actually creates an incentive for a deal, which is why they're relatively calm, in some cases optimistic today.
Yeah, but the United States, from everything that we've read and what you probably know firsthand, Bob, is that the United States apparently wants China to put this stuff in writing, express deals that are made where we can actually enforce this deal against them in China. Effectively, I don't want to say rewrite their laws,
that is,
but it's not far off. And if you're China, why would you ever agree to that?
This is part of the problem. As I see it now from the information I've received, the substance is an issue, but it's not the biggest issue at the moment. There are probably a few gaps on the substance that need to be narrowed or eliminated. The question is, A, how do you put this in writing? And B, how do you find a mechanism for enforcement? And the writing part is important because the Chinese are not about to have the United States, in effect, write their laws. They want to make a deal, and they will then implement the deal in the laws they write and the regulations they promulgate. And I think that that is a matter of national pride and an issue of face. And the U.S. would probably not want other countries to participate in the writing of our laws either. So this is one major problem. And the second is the enforcement. Are the rules of the agreement, of the provisions of the agreement, going to be enforced by unilateral decisions of the United States? Or is there going to be some collective common process for determining if a violation has occurred?
You know, it's like a global game of trade chicken, and everyone expects that, we've talked to you, Bob, the cars will turn away from each other. They will not crash into each other head on. But what if that happens? What are the odds that both sides don't blink and that this spirals out of control? Then what?
Well, I think it really boils down to what President Trump will accept for his domestic purposes and how many concessions or what type of concessions the U.S. expects China to make and how it expects the agreement to be written. And it's possible that they will not be able to reach an agreement. The odds seem to be in the market sort of telling us that it thinks they will. But if there is no agreement, and if you do get a series of escalating tariffs, tariffs will go up on the American side and the Chinese will take retaliatory action if we do that, then this thing could spin out of control.
Yeah.
Fortunately, the administration has said that it will start imposing the sanctions and the higher tariffs, but not right away. So the goods being shipped from China, ending yesterday evening, they will be exempt. So there is really a period of time that still is available before the actual tariffs will hit goods coming into the United States. And that will give breathing room. But if no agreement is reached during this breathing period, then we will have a major problem for both sets of economies. And the markets, which now anticipated an agreement, will then suffer. But that, we still have a little time to go before that occurs.